graduated from Middlesboro High School and was a lifelong member of East Cumberland Avenue Baptist Church in Middlesboro, Kentucky. In addition to being an avid Tennessee ball fan, Joanne loved animals, and she loved people. She never met a stranger. She always had a kind word for everyone. She was always willing to give her hand to help and hand to anyone in need. Joanne was a true angel here on earth. She is preceded in death by her parents, Fraser and Violet Gilbert. Her son, Charles Matthew, or Matt Daniels. And brothers, Fraser Gilbert Jr., Jack Gilbert, and Jim Gilbert. She is survived by her husband, James Bud Pace, and children, Karen Daniels Wilson, and husband, Tom. Mark Daniels, John Daniels, and wife, Sandy. Daughter-in-law, Michelle Woody Daniels, sister-in-law, Inez Wilson, and husband, James. She's also survived by her grandchildren, Matthew Daniels, Andrew Daniels, and wife, Kendall. Allison Crappy, and husband, Daniel, December, Simi Woody, Tori Lee Lovett, and great-granddaughter, Annalise, as well as a host of relatives and friends, including nieces and nephews, who will miss her dearly. Your life is a blessing, remember your treasure, your love beyond words, and miss beyond measure. Who will us bow our heads in a word of prayer, please? Father, we come to you today in Jesus' name. We want to thank you, Lord, for allowing us to know such a wonderful person as Joanne. How kind she was, and how she was so pleasant to speak to and talk to and be around. We pray that today your spirit would be here among us. Lord, we pray that you would lead us and guide us here today, Lord, that you would comfort the family, Lord, She didn't complain. She didn't talk bad about it. She was kind. She was a very pleasant person to talk to. And I looked up a few synonyms for kind, some similar words. Caring, considerate, thoughtful, pleasant, courteous, agreeable, generous, many more. I just jotted down a few of those. There's so many more words that are similar to the word kind we can say about Joanne. This is some, over the book of Ruth in the Old Testament, I begin to think about Ruth. Ruth was a wonderful woman. Her husband had passed away, and she could have went back to her homeland, but she decided to stay with her mother-in-law, Naomi. She decided to stay by her side, and she was faithful all the way through that, even though she didn't have to be. We know the story of Boaz redeemed Ruth, bought her, brought her out of poverty, and Ruth being the great-grandmother of King David. So there's a lot of history there, but this verse is what has come to my mind in Ruth chapter 3 and verse 10. Boaz said here, "Blessed be thou of the Lord, my daughter, for thou hast shown more kindness in the latter end than in the beginning." And I thought about how true that was to Joanne. I didn't know her early in life, but I know toward the end she had shown as much kindness. I've had the privilege of pastoring many people and talking to many people, and I'll assure you that Joanne was one of the most kind people that I had ever had the privilege of pastoring. I thought about that, how kind she was, that she had shown more kindness in the latter end than in the beginning. And the Bible says that charity suffereth long and is kind. That means charity, love, true love, what Joanne had, it lasts, it endures. And that love that she had, that kindness that she had, it comes from no other source than through Jesus Christ. And that love that she was showing back to all of us comes from the love of Jesus Christ that she had. But it said that it suffers long and is kind. It lasts. It goes on there and it says, she showed it more at the beginning, in the latter end than in the beginning. "Inasmuch as thou followest not young men, whether poor or rich." Ruth didn't care whether they were poor or rich. Ruth didn't care what they had done or where they had been. That was another thing I heard from Joanne. She didn't care about your past. She didn't care about what you had done. She just forgave you. She looked beyond that. She was good at that, and that's what the Bible says. The Bible says that love does that. Love thinketh no evil. In other words, true love, what Joanne had, it doesn't count up all the evil. It doesn't keep a checklist of what you've done, what you've not done. It just forgives. Joanne done this. And it goes on down and it says, Luke chapter 3, verse 11, "Now, my daughter, fear not." Boy, I said that. Fear not. The Bible tells us that. The Bible says, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me, what Christ said. "In my Father's house are many mansions. For not so I have told you." Jesus said, "I go away to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also." Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Joab didn't have to have any fear of death. "Even though I go walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me." We as Christians, we don't have to fear death itself. Joab, I'm sure, she became, I'm afraid, I don't like hospitals, none of us do. I'm sure she had that some fears here toward the end. She's not in fear. She has no fear now. There's no fear in her. She's at peace with Christ. That fear is gone. The Bible says that perfect love casteth out fear. She's experiencing that perfect love of Christ right now, where there's no fear. So Boaz told Ruth, "My daughter, fear not." He says, I will do to thee all that thou requirest. In other words, all that you request. Boaz is going to do for Ruth. For all the city of my people doth know that thou art a virtuous woman. So he said, I'm going to do what you request. I'm going to do what right now Boaz said, I'm going to do for you, Ruth, what you've asked. Joanne, at some point in her life, she asked Jesus Christ to save her soul. She asked Christ to come into her life and be her Lord and Savior. And I assure you, Jesus Christ, his promises, they'll stand. What he's promised. And he says, what's in his hand that no man is able to pluck out of my hand? Amen. He sung us all. No scheme of man, nothing can pluck us out of his hand. So Jesus Christ has performed what she had asked him at some point in her life to save her soul. And I thought about this virtuous woman there at that last that said that all the people doth know that thou art a virtuous woman. And there are so many things of Proverbs 31 talking about a virtuous woman. A virtue is just moral excellence, goodness, righteousness. I'm soon to come to a close. Proverbs 31:10 says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She openeth her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. Do you see that kindness there? Mm-hmm. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idols. Her children arise up, and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praiseth her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gates. It's been such an honor to stand over such a wonderful person. Because I realize our hearts are heavy. And I realize that this tabernacle, this tent that we have, we're going to miss it. And, you know, I understand that. I'm so thankful. The Bible tells us that there's a day coming when we'll all, if you've been born again, if you've been saved, we'll all have new bodies. They'll never grow old. They'll never die. They'll never experience diseases and growing old. We can look forward to that. And I pray if there's somebody here, I'm going to have a word of prayer. If there's somebody here, I believe Joanne, if there's somebody who's lost, has never accepted Christ, I believe Joanne would love nothing more than to see somebody give their life to the Lord today. As we close in prayer for just a moment, I pray that if you don't know where you would spend eternity, I pray that you say that prayer so that we can spend eternity with Joanne. We can spend eternity with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We will. Let's bow our heads. Father, we come to you today once again in Jesus' name. We want to thank you for your word. Lord, the strength it gives. Lord, we want to thank you for your spirit here today. Lord, we pray for the families. I know, Lord, that they are mourning the loss of, Lord, a very wonderful woman. Lord, I pray that you would comfort them. I pray that you would strengthen them. You would be with them in the days, the months, and years to come. We pray today, Lord, for someone here who has never, Lord, professed you, who has never asked you to save them, Lord, maybe it's straight away. I pray that today would be that day that they would believe upon you. Lord, they would ask you to be their Lord and Savior right now, Lord. So that they can see Joanne again, so that they can be eternally in heaven with you. We pray that they would make this commitment today. We pray, Lord, that you would just go with this family. We love you so much. We want to praise you for everything you've done, for the time we have with her. We love you so much. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Concludes our services here at the cemetery. Free feed is paid.